Hi, I'm Tom Dick. I'm a math advisor for Texas Instruments, and this video is part of the TI in Focus AP Calculus series. We're going to be using the 2019 BC exam question 2 to look at polar curves on the TI-84. Let's get started here by first of all changing our mode, graphing mode, from function, which we're usually on, to polar. So once I've made that change under mode, I'm ready to go to my Y equals menu, which is now an R equals menu. And our R1 will put in the polar function that was given to us in this problem. That function was 3 times the square root of theta times the sine of theta squared. So I'm entering that as my polar function. And next we'll need to go to our window settings. So I go to Window, and the range that we were given for this function was from theta equal to 0 to theta equal to the square root of pi. So I've entered theta min equal to 0. For theta max, I'm actually going to calculate the square root of pi. So I'm entering that, and it'll change that to a decimal value for us. And there we go. There's the square root of pi. Now the theta step will be the increments that theta steps through as we plot the curve. I'd like to have at least 100 points or so here, so I'm going to make my theta step value just the square root of pi, the length of our interval, divided by 100. So I've entered that, and again it'll calculate that step size for us, and you can see it's 1/100th of my theta max. And then finally, let's do a zoom decimal window. And then here's the curve as it was presented on the exam. It's basically one leaf or petal of a polar curve. Now, one of the questions asked was to find the area of the region bounded by that curve. To do that, we'll do an integral. We'll integrate over the domain of that petal, which was 0 to square root of pi. And to find the area enclosed by a polar curve, given by a function R1 of theta, we'll integrate. Our integrand will be 1/2 times the square of our polar function. So I'm going to the Y variables menu, going to polar, and picking up R1. I need to remember to square that. And then we'll integrate with respect to our independent variable theta. All right, let's see what value we get. There we go, 3.534, and so on. All right, now the next question on BC Free Response Question 2 for 2019 was to find the average distance a point on that curve is from the origin. Now, our domain was from 0 to square root of pi, so the length of our interval is square root of pi minus 0, or square root of pi. So I'm going to multiply my integrand, or integral, by 1 over square root of pi. Now what will we be integrating? Now I've echoed down the integral we had before, but I'm going to edit it. Now 0 to square root of pi is still the correct interval, but all we will need to do is simply integrate R1, because R1 is giving us the distance a point is from the origin for each value theta. So there's our average value given by 1.5799. Okay, let's go to the mode, and we're going to change from polar to parametric. The reason for that is the next part of this question asks us to deal with a line through the origin, and that'll be hard to graph with a polar. So we're going to use parametric instead. I'm going to start out with a slope of m equals 1, and you can see I'm storing 1 in the constant m, and I go to the Y equals menu, which is now showing parametric. Your x1, y1 shows you how you can convert a polar function to a parametric. You just take your function R1, expressed in terms of t, and multiply by cosine t and sine t for your x and y functions. The t, m times t, and x2, y2 will give us our line. Now I've gone to the window settings. I'm going to set t min to 0, t max to square root of pi, because t is now playing the role of theta. And our t step, again, we'll want, let's get at least 100 points. I'm going to set that to 1/100th of my t max value, or approximately that much, 0.0177. That will give us 100 points on the curve. And now let's take a look at the graph. And there we have our original petal and a part of a line. That's because we've only plotted for values from t, 0 to square root of pi. And you can see it has slope 1. Okay, let's look at a new value for our slope m. So I've gone back to the calculator screen, and I'm going to store 2 in m. And then once I've stored that value of m, we can regraph. Take a look at the new picture. There's our polar curve, and now this is a part of a line of slope 2. Now, this question actually asks for what slope of line would divide that region into two subregions of equal area. Well, let's try m equals 3 and see how good a job that does, at least visually. So I've stored 3 in m, I've regraphed, and wow, that looks like it's pretty close. Those, at least visually, it looks like I've come close to dividing the region into two subregions of equal area. This part of the question actually asked us to set up an equation that would let us solve for m. Now we're going to actually carry out that solution. I'll show you how. We're going to the math menu, and I'm going to the last entry, which is the numeric solver. And I've gone ahead and entered two integrals. One of them represents the area up to the line, and that line makes an angle of inverse tangent of the slope with the positive x-axis. The second integral runs from that angle theta, corresponding to the inverse tangent of the slope, to the square root of pi. And my numeric solver takes those two expressions, sets them equal, and we can ask it to solve for m. It has the latest value we had for m, and then when we solve, we get the value 3.0432 and so on. And we can see we really were fairly close, but that gives us a much more accurate answer to our equation. Okay, moving on to the last part of this problem. We're going to introduce a second curve. So I've gone back, changed my mode back to polar. We still have our R1 as before. And we're asked to consider a second curve, k times cosine of theta. So I've entered that as my R2. K is a constant. We'll need to give it some kind of value. Let's just try 1. So I'm going to go back to the calculator screen and store 1 in for k. And then let's go to the window settings. Now, R2 is actually going to trace out a circle, but we'll need to increase our domain to 0 to pi. I still want 100 points on each of the curves, so I'll change my theta step to 1/100th of pi, at least approximately. So that's that. And you can see with that larger domain, we're seeing much more of our R1 curve, more than that first petal. But R2 is giving us this circle, which is actually fairly tiny. It just has a radius of 1/2. It goes through the origin, and its center is at 1/2 0. Let's try another value of k. Let's try 3, and we'll store that in k, and then regraph. So we've stored 3 into k. Let's look at our new picture. And then when we graph, we get our polar curve, and now we see we have a circle of radius 3/2. It still goes through the origin. And notice that it's forming a subregion. It's that region that's inside both the petal of our polar curve and that circle. We're asked what's the limiting value of that area as k approaches infinity. Well, just to get an idea, let's store a large value in for k and consider what that picture looks like. So I've stored 100 for k. What's that graph going to look like? Oh, well, there's our polar curve as we would expect, but we can see we have a very large circle, in fact, a circle of radius 50. And we can see as k gets bigger and bigger, we're essentially getting closer and closer to a region that really is just going to be determined by the positive y-axis. Now, that angle corresponds to theta equal to pi over 2. So if we want that limiting area, we can just go back to the calculator screen, and we'll integrate from 0 to pi over 2. And again, since we're integrating for a polar area, we'll integrate 1/2 times our polar function r1. So I go to y variables, pick up the polar r1, and remember that we need to square that. And then we'll integrate with respect to our independent variable theta, and we get a final answer of 3.32447, and so on. All right, that completes that question and winds up this video. For more resources like these, see education.ti.com.